everyone, so I am here today in my John, Mary, Percy, and George shirt because it is National Poetry Month in the US and that means that I want to talk about poetry. So I read a lot of poetry, as you might know if you've been watching my videos about books for a while, or if you know me in real life and know that I write a lot about poetry. I write poetry and I read poetry. So this is a video that I wanted to compile for a few different reasons. One, because it is National Poetry Month in the US. I live in Australia, but the US influences the rest of the world. And because I had a lot of friends recently ask me for some poetry recommendations, and I thought that this would be a really nice moment to spur on my poetry recommendations video that I've been planning for a few weeks now. So the purpose of this video is basically to give three different ways that you can approach reading poetry, or to start reading poetry, or to read more poetry if you feel like you're not across the genre, or if you're intimidated by it, or if you haven't read any since you studied it in school. I am not a fan of the way that the majority of English-speaking school systems teach poetry. I think it's really intimidating and it leaves a lot of students alienated from poetry, which means that later in life they continue to think that it's elitist and impenetrable and not like reading books. So anyway, I'm just gonna jump in and let you know three different ways that I recommend starting to read poetry or reading more poetry. My first recommendation is to read anthologies. I have two different kinds of anthologies here to show you. The first one is an American collection. This is the BreakBeat Poets, New American Poetry in the Age of Hip Hop, edited by Kevin Coval, Quraysh, Ali, Lansana, and Nate Marshall. So as you can tell from the title, this is a collection of poems from the hip-hop generation. A lot of it is lyrics to hip-hop and a lot of it is influenced by hip-hop as well. It's a really excellent collection. A lot of African-American writers are people of color from around the world as well, and it's just a really excellent collection if you're already listening to a lot of rap or hip-hop, if you really like that kind of style, or if you just think that song lyrics are very similar to poetry anyway. It's a really nice accessible collection. I'd recommend this to anyone. And then I also have here, these are the best Australian poems from 2013 and 2008. This one was edited by Peter Rose. This one was edited by Lisa Gorton. These are published every single year here in Australia, though I have heard that Black Ink Books, the publisher that publishes these, has decided to cease continuing to publish them, which is really disappointing, but also a testament to the fact that people aren't reading as much poetry as I would like them to. These are published in Australia, but I'm pretty sure you can purchase them internationally as well, and I know for certain that America does publish the best American poems of whatever year it may be. These are just two that I have. These are really excellent ways to read a wide variety of styles and writers. If you feel a little bit too intimidated by the idea of picking up a single collection from a single author that you may have never read before or have only known through school or something, this can be really great because it means you can kind of dabble with a few different writers, see which styles you like, and then investigate them a little bit further after that. It means you're not really committing too strongly to a certain style that you might not end up liking in the long run. Another great way to get into poetry, and one of the main ways that I got into poetry, was through spoken word poets. Here on YouTube there is heaps of resources for you to access spoken word poets. If you're interested in subscribing to some spoken word channels, then I can link some that I follow down below, and they publish really regularly different spoken word recordings, either of competitions or people that work for them, like Button Poetry does a lot of competitions and open mics, but they also have some regular performers as well. I'll have them all linked down below in case you want to look at how spoken word is actually spoken. But also, spoken word poets do also publish their own work as well. The first one I have here is No Matter the Wreckage by Sarah Kay. A lot of people know Sarah Kay as a spoken word poet. She's also given a few TED Talks and is pretty active online as a spoken word and now published poet. This was her first collection, and it was one I picked up because I was pretty influenced by Sarah Kay when I first started writing spoken word poetry a few years ago, and I just think she's really accessible and a great one to start with, or to read later on in life, it doesn't really matter. And then this one a lot of people have heard of. This is Hold Your Own by Kate Tempest. This is a collection that she published all circling around the story of Tiresias and some other Greek myths that she writes about. It won the Ted Hughes Award for Poetry, so a lot of people came to her through that. Kate Tempest was originally a rapper and then she became a spoken word poet. She also has written plays and a novel, so she has quite a few published works at this point in time. She became really popular in Australia a few years ago when she came on Q&A and performed one of her spoken word poems in collaboration with the Sydney Writers Festival a few years ago. This is my favorite of her collections that I have read so far. It's not really a spoken word collection, it's more of a just written collection, but she does have a few poems in here that I have seen her perform before. So these two are just really great ways of accessing through the internet poetry through spoken word, which can be typically more accessible than written poetry because it's easier to process words through hearing them instead of reading them sometimes. These are just two collections from two of my favorite spoken word poets, though there are plenty out there. And lastly, contemporary poetry. I think this can probably be the hardest region to penetrate because you don't study a lot of contemporary poetry in high school or even at university, so it's really difficult to kind of gain that access point into the different writers and the different styles that are available to you. So I just have two here that I would recommend as starting points or as just ones that you might be interested in trying out. The first one, this is Bone by Yrsa Daley-Ward. A lot of people on YouTube I've been talking about this recently because it was recently published and I think quite a few people got sent this. This is a really lovely collection. She speaks a lot about body politics, a lot about interpersonal relationships with men and with women, a lot about self-image and self-esteem and things like that. Not to be rude, would typically recommend this to someone who has read Ruby Core and wants something a little bit more challenging or a little bit more poetic. This is a really great one to go to after her. And if you live in Sydney, Yrsa is coming to the Sydney Writers Festival this year. She's giving a few talks about this collection. And also, this is There Are More Beautiful Things Than Beyonce by Morgan Parker. Morgan Parker is an African-American writer who has written a few collections. This is the one that I have picked up so far. I picked it up because of the very shiny cover and because it was called There Are More Beautiful Things Than Beyonce. This has a lot of pop cultural references in it. There are a lot of poems about Beyonce and there are a lot of poems about just general celebrities, especially African American celebrities or people of color in the public eye. This is a really interesting examination of race as well as femininity and sexuality. I really liked this collection. I would recommend it to pretty much anyone. I bought this as my book club's Kris Kringle present because I think it's a really great way to access poetry, especially contemporary poetry that doesn't have to be about nature. It can be about things that you care about, like celebrities or pop culture or internet culture. So there you go. Those are just a few different ways that I think that you can access reading more poetry or get used to reading more poetry if you are intimidated or if you just want a few more recommendations. Because I know it can be really difficult, one, to afford buying poetry collections because they're so expensive, and to just generally find a style that you're interested and engaged with, I have linked down below recordings of myself reading a poem from each of the collections that I recommended today, so you get a general taste of the style of each of the writers, and you can better understand whether or not you would like to purchase or investigate further collections from those writers. They are all unlisted links, so if you want to access them, you have to follow the links that I've put in the description, otherwise you won't be able to find them on YouTube. So there you go. Those are different tips for me and different recommendations on how to read more poetry. If you have any questions or any recommendations of your own, please leave them down below. Also, let me know if there are any other poetry type videos you would like me to make. I know quite a bit about poetry and I would really love to share it. I want more people to read poetry all the time. I have been tossing around the idea of doing a video about classics or modern classics, the kind of poetry you would have read in school and how you can read it differently now that you're out of school so that you actually enjoy it. But anyway, that's my video for today. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great National Poetry Month and I'll see you later.